we're reimagining air conditioning to meet the global cooling demand increase and to combat climate change. We're working on a novel technology that combines material science and design to provide environmentally positive, low-cost air conditioning that can be applied in most climates without the use of synthetic refrigerants.
As global temperatures increase, the cooling demand is expected to triple by 2050. That's the equivalent of 10 new air conditioners every second for the next 30 years. Almost 9.5 billion new air conditioners. The vast majority of air conditioners today rely on the same century-old technology, which requires a lot of electricity and refrigerant chemicals that are up to 10,000 times more potent than CO2 at contributing to climate change.
To solve this problem, we've turned to an ancient technology that's been used for thousands of years in civilizations like Egypt and Persia, and that's evaporative cooling. This technology typically works in hot and dry climates. We've added a unique material solution that allows us to cool at a lower temperature and to use our technology in more humid climates.
Our air conditioners use ceramic, one of the oldest known building materials, which we have enhanced with a super hydrophobic barrier layer, which allows us to separate moisture from air as it's cooled. The coating acts as a nanoscale barrier to limit the diffusion of both water in liquid phase and vapor phase, allowing us to sensibly cool the air through water evaporation without an increase in humidity.
The inspiration for our approach comes in a big way from biological systems. If we think about desert beetles or cacti, they evolved strategies to deal with high temperatures and humidity in an interesting way. In particular, strategies that combine hydrophobic and hydrophilic areas in the same organism or in the same plant. By developing this combination of designated areas in our new type of heat exchanger, such that cooling is taking place in one area, but evaporation takes place in another area. In this way, humidity doesn't reach the space where we need to have cooling that can provide solution for probably the main problem in evaporative cooling, that as you cool, it becomes very uncomfortable because humidity levels go up and up.
We've partnered with Fabricar, a Spanish architectural ceramics expert, to manufacture a prototype of this air cooling system.
Ceramics are one of the most environmentally friendly building materials. They don't require a lot of fossil fuel energy to make, and most ceramic building products contain about 50% recycled content. We recycle 100% of the water in the production process itself, achieving zero dumping of wastewater. We are excited to push innovation in ceramics forward to create more sustainable cooling systems.
We need to combine efforts from completely different backgrounds. In particular, even in this work with heat exchangers, probably nothing could be done if it wouldn't be interactions between this institute, Beacon School of Engineering, Graduate School of Design. The outcome of our laboratory testing is now to have our new heat exchanger installed in House Zero, a special building that was designed to look how new technologies can be implemented, what is their energy input, what exactly one should expect, not only at the lab scale, but in fact at the scale of an entire building.
We're hoping to see how well it performs outside the lab and prove that our prototype can provide a more effective way of cooling with less impact on our environment.
This morning, as we started at 8 a.m., we removed one of the existing windows from House Zero. From then on, we're installing a custom wooden frame. Once that's secured to the house, we're going to install our prototype units. There's two, and then we'll start testing tomorrow.
We're going to be running it for multiple days, and throughout that period, we're going to see how much cooling it can produce, how dry the air is that's coming into the space, and ultimately, how efficient or effective is the unit at cooling. After multiple days of record temperature, we're showing that the unit is an effective way of cooling and that we can do that at a much lower energy consumption than a typical refrigerant-based AC unit.
We're reimagining air conditioners
to meet the global cooling demand
and combat climate change.